There's a brand new study out that's been getting a lot of press. It compared identical twins on either a vegan or an omnivore diet, and they looked at their biological age. So chronological age is just time. How long has it been since I was born? Biological age is how aged I am, my tissues or my physiology. And two people born on the same day can age at different rates. I think we all know that. So they tried to ask, do these two diets, vegan and omnivore, affect the rate of aging differently? And this was part of the twin study out of Stanford. We've looked at this before, their main study, looking at body weight and blood work. We've covered that in a previous video. There's also a Netflix show looking at the study that was kind of controversial. We've looked at that as well. So this new paper is looking at the same set of 20-ish pairs of twins, randomly split. One of the twins goes on the vegan diet, the other twin goes on the omnivore diet, and then they're followed for 8 weeks on those diets. And this study specifically focused on this question of the rate of aging. So how are they measuring this rate of aging? Using what's called epigenetics. So our genetics is just our DNA code that we inherit from our parents, but the same code can be expressed differently. Genes can be turned on or off. So scientists can measure chemical modifications to the DNA that regulate the function of our genes. And these chemical modifications change with age. There's kind of an age signature to our DNA, kind of like chemical wrinkles that accumulate on our DNA with age. And epigenetic age is known to be affected, to be influenced by our environment, by our behavior, by our lifestyle. Smoking, for example, increases our biological age. So they asked, okay, what effect do these two diets have on our epigenetic age, our biological age? They essentially found that the twins randomized to the vegan diet had a change to their epigenetic signature to a younger pattern. So biologically, a little younger after the 8 weeks on the diet than before the diet. Almost like it turned back their epigenetic clock a little. And the twins on the omnivore diet, on the other hand, saw no significant change over the 8 weeks. They also looked at epigenetic signatures related to specific tissues, and they found a reduction, a rejuvenation in biological age of 5 organ systems or physiological processes on the vegan diet. Inflammation, heart function, hormones, liver, and general metabolic function. Whereas the twins on the omnivore diet saw no significant change. They also looked at telomeres. Telomeres are the caps on the end of our chromosomes, and they usually get smaller with age as cells divide. But they actually saw an increase in the average telomere length, by some measures at least, in the twins assigned to the vegan diet, although there was some discrepancy depending on which method they used. On the other hand, the twins assigned to the omnivore diet, no significant change to telomere length. And they also looked at epigenetic signatures, epigenetic changes that are related to the risk of diabetes. And this was a bit mixed. On the twins on the vegan diet, changes to one DNA site indicated an increase in diabetes risk, whereas to another site indicated a decreased risk. So unclear. And the twins on the omnivore diet, no significant difference to either site. So what does all this mean? Kind of similar to the conclusions of their main study, looking at the general epigenetic data, suggests that the twins on the vegan diet benefited a bit more health-wise. But the question, just as we saw with the first video, is whether these changes are because the diet is vegan or whether it's something else about the intervention. So this is the same caveat as the original study. And by the way, the authors are very clear about this. They state it very clearly in their study, in their discussion. So they're very aware of this. So one obvious confounder, for example, is that the vegans ended up eating fewer calories, about 200 a day, less than the folks on the omnivore diets. And as a result, they lost more weight, about 1.5 kilos over the 8 weeks. So the results could be reflecting the weight loss rather than the diet being vegan specifically. In fact, there is a trial published not long ago called the calorie trial. And this was a randomized trial where they cut calories by 25%, but it wasn't a vegan diet specifically. And then they followed the participants for 2 years and they saw a rejuvenation of one of these epigenetic metrics that also was reduced in the twin study on the vegan diet. So calories by themselves do seem to have an effect on epigenetic age, on biological age. Although there were two other epigenetic metrics that were significantly improved, rejuvenated in this twin study, that were not significantly changed in the calorie study So it is theoretically possible that there's something else going on here. It's always really tricky to compare across different studies because they look at different populations, they have different designs. But it's interesting to note, for example, that this study, although it had a very short duration, only 8 weeks, saw a change in several of these metrics of biological age. So I think that's surprising. I wouldn't necessarily have expected these changes for a study that is so short. Other trials have looked at the effect of diet on biological age, on epigenetic age, by looking at other healthy dietary patterns, like the Mediterranean diet, for example, that are not a vegan diet per se, but have a lot of fruits and vegetables, unprocessed plants, have a focus on sources of unsaturated fats like fish, seafood, olive oil. And several of these trials have reported some epigenetic rejuvenation after 1 or 2 years on these diets. So being aware of all this context, it's possible that the results of this study are due to the weight loss. It's possible that they're due to one of the features that are shared by all of these diets, like the fiber content, for example, a high fiber diet or a high plant diet. Or it's possible that there is some component here that is specific to the vegan diet. But this trial, this design, can't really uncouple all those possibilities. It would be really interesting to see a vegan diet compared to another diet that is not vegan, but similar calories. That would allow us to uncouple some of these factors. The other limitation, and this is kind of obvious, is that these patterns of epigenetics, these signatures, aren't the same as actually following a population for decades and recording who dies and seeing kind of their actual longevity. There are other data sets that look at mortality and actual deaths on different diets, like the Adventists Health Study, for example, but they're usually not randomized. That's usually the trade-off. With randomized trials, usually you have a shorter duration, a few years if you're lucky, and with for really long data sets for really long follow-ups of decades, it's almost always not randomized. So there's actually a new analysis from the Adventist Health Study that just dropped about a week ago, coincidentally, and they found that all-cause mortality, total deaths in vegans, were not significantly different from omnivores overall. So in the Adventist Health Study, they used their omnivores or the meat eaters as a reference, and then every other diet, every other group is compared to that. Then they broke down the results by age and also by sex, and they did see a significant reduction in the vegans only for males and only when recorded at age 65. For older males, recorded at 85, or for females, no significant difference compared to omnivores. The group that reduced deaths most consistently compared to omnivores was actually pescatarians. They had between 10 and 25% lower all-cause mortality than the omnivores. And it was significant at both ages they looked at and in both sexes. Now, people often ask, I've heard this question many times, if it's because of supplementation, maybe the vegans weren't taking B12, or maybe it's the omega-3s. The pescatarians obviously are going to get their DHA, EPA from fish or seafood, and the vegans aren't taking, usually most vegans aren't taking algae oil or anything like that. So the question is, okay, if the vegans were supplementing with omega-3s with some algae oil or fish oil or something, maybe they would perform just as well or maybe even better. We can speculate all day. Right now, the answer is we don't know. And these are the results we have. On this topic of diets and mortality and longevity, people often ask about the blue zones. And we've talked about it before at length. We have a whole video going over what they are, their findings, and their limitations. And I'm going to put that right here. And here's that video on the Netflix show about the twin study. That was actually pretty popular, kind of controversial. Check those out. I'll meet you over there. Take care.